though it still felt like one of the best vehicles in its class, the Honda Civic was actually getting a little bit old. So it's time for a new generation. This is the 2022 Honda Civic, the 11th generation of Honda's legendary compact model. They've done a ton of improvements here. We've got some improvements under the hood, a radically new exterior, and some huge improvements on the interior. Today, I'm going to show you what the 11th generation Civic is all about. So let's start by doing an exterior walk around of the 2022 Civic. It looks radically different from the outgoing model. You can see Honda has gone for a much more mature styling character here, and mature is another way of saying boring. It's not as funky as the outgoing Civic, but I think this might appeal to a broader audience. And I definitely think Honda was sending me a not so coded message by sending me one in silver, my least favorite of all of the car colors. You can see that they've gone away with the sort of roundy headlights in favor of a more rectangular, horizontal approach, making it look much more like the larger, more handsome Accord. They've lowered the belt line here, giving this a much sleeker, much less roundy look. And they've really just improved the styling overall with a longer dash to axle ratio, giving this car a very handsome look. It's not ugly by any respect, just a little bit less exciting than the previous model. We do have the touring here, so we have these nice 18-inch wheels. There are a bunch of other wheel options available, including 16s and 17s. You can see the roof line has been lowered across the board on this model, and the wheelbase has actually been extended by 1.4 inches. It's almost 108 inches long, the longest in the compact class. This is almost nearing mid-sized territory. That's how big this model is. And you can see back here, radically different, much cleaner than the outgoing Civic, which was very crazy, very bubbly, very cool with the center exhaust and all of that. I'm not as big of a fan of this. I like wacky, outrageous styling, but I think that more people are going to like Honda's new conservative approach. Now let's hop inside the 2022 Civic, where the interior has changed drastically over the outgoing model. Honda calls this a human-centered approach, making it more usable between you and the computers, and I think they've done that really well. It's a very clean sheet design. For the first time ever, we have a digital gauge cluster measuring 10.2 inches on a color LCD display for your speedo and your tachometer. Looks really nice. You even get a little Civic in there that does the brake lights and the turn signals as well as you do them in real time. Really nice materials here on this touring trim. We've got leather seats heated on this model, leather steering wheel with paddle shifters, very nice feeling in here, leather on the shifter as well. All of the buttons and switchgear are super metallic, very clicky, very nice feel to them, almost Mazda quality. That's how good Honda has done here in terms of just the quality, fit, and finish of this new Civic. In terms of infotainment, we have two options. There is a base 7-inch touchscreen that does have Apple CarPlay and Android Auto. If you get this larger 9-inch display, which is what we have here, those become wireless, so you don't need to connect your phone and plug it in, which allows you to use the wireless charger positioned down here. Now you can see they've changed up the design. It is much more mature looking than the old sort of one color. It was sort of like a red home screen. They've sort of gone for a more colorful, yet more mature layout here with these sort of ribbon of buttons right here. As you can see, the response is much quicker than before. It's going back and forth very quickly between the different menus. And I love this feature down here. You have these smart shortcuts here at the bottom. Those actually populate based on how you use the vehicle. So as you can see, Bluetooth audio, phone, FM. I've been using those a lot this week, so they've populated down there for me to make it very convenient. I do like that. And I do like how there are some physical controls here, home, back, a volume knob, and your forward and backward buttons right here. Now, the dash layout has changed in the center console quite dramatically. We now have the wireless charger here, shifter, cup holders here, drive mode selector, brake hold, all of that instead of having that very deep cubby, which I really did like the cubby on the old one, but this is much more conventional. And I absolutely love these air vents. You have this metal, like honeycomb grate in front of it. It is real metal. And you have these little controls for the vents that are positioned behind it. Really good way to sort of make this look cleaner without just having air vents. Honda, really cool design element right there. And the other new thing that has never been on a Civic before is now we have premium audio available on this touring trim. It is a Bose system with 12 speakers. Sounds pretty good. Good way to take the Civic from being a very mainstream car to feeling a bit more premium. So. As I mentioned earlier in the video, the Civic has a longer wheelbase than it did before, and that is going to result in some really good legroom. We've got 79.7 inches of combined legroom between the front and the back. 37.4 of those are dedicated to the rear. So as you can see, I'm very comfortable here. Lots of legroom here. We don't have any air vents on this vehicle. That's pretty rare in this segment, but at least we do have two USB ports to charge up our devices. And finally, we conclude with the trunk space, which is really good. It's actually slightly larger than the outgoing Civic. We've got 14.8 cubic feet of space in most models. The Touring is actually gonna have a little bit less, 14.4 cubic feet. I think that's because the speakers maybe take up just a little bit of that space. If you need more trunk space than this, you probably are gonna wait for the Civic hatchback, which is gonna be sort of a more lift back style here. That should improve the trunk space even more. All right, so now it's time to get the new 2022 Civic out on the road. And this is an area where Honda could not afford to mess this car up because the Civic has always been among the best driving vehicles in its class. And this one, I'm gonna tell you, is no exception. This thing is an absolute delight. Could be rocketed right to the top of this already really good compact segment. They've improved the steering even more. And just remember, this is not the SI, this is not the Type R, this is just the regular old Civic that normal people are going to buy. And the steering tuning is fantastic. It has such a nice balance. You get a really nice feel on center, and then it just weights up even more as you take it off center. It's just a really, really nice feeling overall. Now, they've got two engine options available before you start getting into the SI and Type R, which are not out yet. The base motor is a 2-liter four-cylinder VTEC engine with the most base horsepower you're gonna get in this class, 158 with 138 pound-feet of torque. Now, we don't have that engine. We have the top touring trim, which only comes with the 1.5-liter turbocharged engine that does run on 87 octane fuel. Now, this engine is much more potent with 180 horsepower and 177 pound-feet of torque. That's 6 more horsepower and 15 pound-feet more than you used to get in the outgoing Civic Turbo. And this one actually has VTEC now, whereas the old 1.5 did not, but it's not really the VTEC you're thinking of. Whereas the old VTEC was on a normally aspirated engine and it opened up the valves as you got higher up in the rev range to deliver more power. This type of engine, because it's turbocharged, doesn't actually need that type of technology. So while they have put the VTEC back into this engine, it's only on the valves for the exhaust ports. And basically what that's going to do is give you better fuel economy. VTEC just improved efficiency, yo. And no matter which engine you choose, it's going to be sending power to the front wheels only through a continuously variable transmission. There is no manual transmission, so if you like to row the gears yourself, you're gonna have to wait for the Civic hatchback, or as I mentioned, one of those sportier SI or Type R models, which are only gonna come with a 6-speed manual transmission, which is pretty cool. Now, I will say that they have improved this CVT greatly. It is a really, really good one. It kind of simulates gears, but not in an obnoxious way where it really feels like the RPMs are dropping and lowering. It feels like they've struck a really nice balance between maximizing the horsepower and torque and not making it feel too droney like some CVTs. Now, the suspension is 20% smoother on this new Civic, and there is an 8% improvement in torsional rigidity. That's all great for the driving experience, and they've packed so much more clever sound deadening in this car, so it is very quiet in here. This is a very, very refined experience as well. There is some drive modes here that you can play with. You've got Sport, Normal, and Econ, and really what that's gonna do is mess with the CVT programming and just, you know, let you rev it out a little bit more or a little bit less, depending on the mode. And I find that no matter which one I'm in, the Civic is just an absolute delight to drive. And I've got to talk to you about the safety tech on this car, because it is probably top of the class right now. It's called Honda Sensing. You get a ton of it as standard with a little bit added optionally on higher trims like this touring model. Honda has improved the adaptive cruise control programming, so it feels a lot more natural. It has a lot wider vision, so it can really tell what the car in front of it is doing and respond early. The adaptive steering is among the best I've tested at any price level. It really feels like the car is locking onto the road and you can really feel it doing a lot of the steering for you. Now, it's not a hands-free system, but it almost feels like it could be. It's that good. I've experienced systems like this on $70,000 or $80,000 luxury cars, but to see it on a $30,000 Civic is absolutely amazing. And my favorite part about this car is that they've managed to improve the efficiency this year. It's funny because even though this 1.5-liter turbocharged engine is more powerful than the base 2-liter, it's actually more efficient. In this touring trim, you're going to get 31 mpg in the city, 38 on the highway, and 34 combined. If you get the EX trim, which is below this, you'll do even better. You'll get 33 in the city, 42 on the highway, and 36 combined. And the numbers for the 2-liter are pretty good as well. No matter which engine you choose, you're going to get great efficiency. So all around, I think the new Honda Civic is probably a best-in-class driving experience. So that was the 2022 Honda Civic. Pricing for the base LX trim starts at under $22,000 before around a $1,000 destination charge. There's a sport trim with the 2-liter engine, and then you can step up to the EX for about $24,000, get you the 1.5 liter turbo. Now, if you want the touring trim as we have it, that's over $28,000, and you can add sort of an HBD package. It's very cool. You get like wheels and other styling elements from Honda. A neat little option to maybe consider, but I think this touring trim is fantastic if you can afford the money. I'd maybe step down to that EX trim with the 1.5 liter turbo because this engine is so great. I love the power, I love the torque, I love the smoothness of it, and you get better efficiency than the base engine. All of the improvements Honda have made here is fantastic. I'm going to hold back reservations on the styling until I get to see the SI and the Type R model, but as it sits, I think the 2022 Honda Civic is probably the benchmark of its class. We really hope you've enjoyed this review of the 2022 Honda Civic. For more videos just like it, be sure to check out our channel, hit the subscribe button and the notification bell to be alerted of our latest videos. I'll see you next time.